Good morning. Welcome to your graduation ceremony. Congratulations on all your achievements. Today is about you, so relax, take it all in, and enjoy the experience. You'll receive your testament from staff who will be located in the Eastern Hall as you make your way to the stage. You will then carry your testament with you as you cross the stage and stand on the cross that is 1.5 distance from the Chancellor or Presider. If you're wearing a mask, you may wish to remove this before you cross the stage, as your photo will be taken. We recommend either removing your mask and leaving it at your seat, or removing it before you step on the stage, place it in your pocket or out of sight. We now have a couple of videos to play for you to demonstrate what will happen during your ceremony. Here's the first part.
Welcome to your graduation ceremony, and congratulations on your achievements. Today is about you, so relax, take it all in, and most of all, enjoy it. Before we begin, please remember to either turn off your mobile phone or switch it to silent. Keep any belongings like bags or umbrellas under your seat and leave them there when it's time to cross the stage. Speaking of seats, make sure you're sitting in yours. Seats will be labelled with a program containing your seat number and name. The order you're sitting in is the order which you'll be presented on stage. So stay in your allocated seat and leave any empty seats unfilled, as people may arrive late. When it's time to make your way to the stage, look to staff in black polo tops. They'll prompt you to stand row by row and let you know where to walk. Staff may also be wearing white polo shirts or a graduation gown, so make sure you follow their direction at all times. Before you cross the stage, there'll be three checkpoints: at the middle doors, just before the stage, and on stage. At each point, say your name clearly but quietly to staff, who check you're in the correct order. If you're sitting on stage, staff will let you know before the ceremony what you need to do when collecting your testament. When you're in position on stage, step up to the black line. When your full name's announced, walk along the carpet to the Chancellor or Presider.
When you reach the staff member standing on stage, your name will be checked. You'll be then asked to stand on the black line. I'll demonstrate this for you in a second. When your name is announced, you'll be required to walk across the stage and stand next to the Chancellor, Representative. Please hold your testament on your right side facing forward, so it is positioned between yourself and the Chancellor. Ensure that you're facing forwards as the photographer will take your photo. We will now play the remainder of the video to explain what you need to do after your photo has been taken.
Walk through the side door to leave the stage and walk down the corridor. Take care, as the wooden floor is well polished and can be slippery in high heels. At the middle doors, turn left to re-enter the hall and use the middle aisle to return to your seat. There, you'll remain seated until the end of the ceremony. If you have any questions, please ask our friendly staff. And once again, congratulations, and have a wonderful day.
After you leave the stage, you're presented with an alumni bag by a staff member from the alumni team. We recommend that you do not use this bag to carry your testament, as it's not quite big enough and could cause the edges of your testament to be damaged. There is a fee involved if you would like to order a replacement testament. Please be aware that the ceremony is live streamed and you'll be able to watch it on the university website or official YouTube page. Your mortarboard should sit flat on your head with a tassel on the left side towards the front. Please make sure that you adjust the Velcro strap on the back of the mortarboard just to ensure that it fits your head correctly. If you're wearing stilettos, please be very careful walking along the walls of the hall, as there are grates on the floor and your heels can become stuck in them. Staff will help you check your academic dress in the corridor before you step onto stage. Please let the staff know if you do not wish them to adjust that for you. At the end of the ceremony, you'll be prompted to walk two by two as part of the academic recession to exit Benython Hall. If you need to use the toilet, please do so after this briefing. If you move from your seat once the ceremony starts, you may miss out on being presented. Once you're outside, enjoy the day with your family and friends. Once again, guys, congratulations on all your achievements. Thank you.
graduates, congratulations.
You did it.
Well done and congratulations.
You now join a very, very special list of elite people from around the globe.
Alongside astronauts,
prime ministers,
and everything in between.
It's now your time.
You've joined a global community
of achievers, believers,
innovators, and creators.
A community of history makers.
We know that these are big shoes to fill,
but we also know that you've got this.
It's a great thing to reach the end point and to celebrate your graduation today.
Well done, and congratulations.
And not just to you, but to your mum, your dad,
your grandma, your grandpa,
aunts, uncles, your dog, cat,
and even your pet iguana.
They've all supported you to achieve your best.
Be proud of what you've done.
We certainly are.
So for you guys now,
take a breath,
drink it in, watch some Netflix.
Go on, you've earned it.
And know that the world is ready for you.
And you're ready for the world.
In a year of making history and living it,
we can't wait to see what history you'll make
as graduates of the University of Adelaide.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, and welcome to the University of Adelaide graduation ceremony. This afternoon's ceremony is for the graduates from Faculty of Sciences, Engineering and Technology. The ceremony will commence very shortly. The university has a contract photographer to provide photography service during the ceremony. If you wish to take photos, I would ask that you do so discreetly from your seat, and please do not use flash. To maintain the ceremony's sense of occasion, please switch off your mobile phones. In the case of an emergency, please follow the direction of staff members. The emergency assemble point is the Goodman Crescent Lawns to the western side of Benifen Hall, and the evacuation plan can be found on page 9 of your program. For safety reasons, guests are not entered the galleries upstairs, and please do not sit on the steps in the balcony area. Thank you and enjoy the ceremony. The academic procession is about to enter the hall. We'll be singing the national anthem. The words are on page 8 of your program. Please now stand if you are comfortably able to do so for the academic procession and remain standing for the national anthem.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to this special occasion. I hope that you didn't get too wet waiting to come into the building today. I, Janet Finlay, Chair of the Risk Committee of the University of Adelaide, declare open this congregation convened for the purpose of presenting degrees. Distinguished guests, parents, relatives, friends, and especially our graduates, welcome to the University of Adelaide's graduation ceremony. We acknowledge the Kaurna people, past and present, the original custodians of the Adelaide Plains, and thus of the land on which the University of Adelaide campuses are built. We acknowledge the Kaurna people's ongoing spiritual connection with this land. Graduates, your graduation is an event in which you and your family and friends can take great pride. It is also a source of pride and satisfaction for the university. Graduation day is an opportunity for you to reflect both on the past and on the future. This day may well signal a significant change in direction in your life. Whatever directions your life may take from here, the knowledge that you have acquired and the skills that you have learned and developed here should stand you in good stead, not only in your working and professional life, but we hope in all aspects of your future life. It now gives me great pleasure to introduce you to today's graduation orator, Ms. Catherine Sayer. Catherine Sayer is Chief Executive Officer of Food South Australia, Inc., the state's peak industry body for food and beverage manufacturers and producers. Catherine is passionate about and committed to developing Australia's food and beverage industry. At Food South Australia, Catherine leads a team of staff based in Adelaide, China, and Japan, and works with all levels of government as an advocate for the sector. Catherine graduated with a degree in business management, majoring in marketing. Prior to taking up the challenge of establishing and leading Food South Australia, Catherine's roles have included working in both the public and private sector and managing her own marketing consultancy. She has worked with businesses at every stage of development, ranging from startup enterprises to large established firms. Catherine is also a member and graduate of the Australian Institute of Company Directors. Catherine is currently chair of the Tropical Tuna Management Advisory Committee, a Commonwealth fishery, chair of Kin Premium Seafood, director of Seafood Industry Australia, member of the Aquaculture Tenure Allocation Board and the Glenelg Football Club Board. She is also a Deputy Chair of the Agri-Food and Commerce Committee at the Royal Agricultural and Horticultural Society and a member of the University of Adelaide's Industry Advisory Board and a mentor for the MBA program. A very busy lady. We are privileged to hear Catherine speak today. Please welcome Catherine Sayer.
Well, thank you very much, Janet, and can I acknowledge Ms. Janet Finlay, the Chair of the Risk Committee, to Professor Anton Middleberg, Deputy Vice-Chancellor of Research, the faculty of the University of Adelaide, distinguished guests, and most importantly, all the graduates here today. It's such an exciting day for you all. I'm sure many people have said it, but it's especially significant given you have spent most of your studying time navigating through COVID. Not quite like my days when I spent most of my time in the uni bar. I want to first paint a picture about the South Australian agribusiness sector and then talk a little bit more about my career. In 2021-22, primary industries and agribusiness revenue increased by 12%, totaling $17.3 billion, while the sector also supported 71,000 jobs. Combined gross food and wine revenue increased by 9.8% to reach $24 billion, with increases in food commodities exports as the main driver. Whether you are from the School of Agriculture, Food and Wine, or School of Biological Sciences, we are in a growing industry and all your qualifications will continue to contribute to that growth. Our industry is truly the backbone of our economy, and we are so fortunate to have such great linkages between primary production and superior food and wine, which is recognised globally. Congratulations on joining such a great industry and community. And I say community because in my world, food and beverage, we are well connected and collaborative. I followed a very traditional path when I left school, having received a matric result to get me into a business degree majoring in marketing. I was 16 when I left school and way too young to know what I really wanted to do. So my background is in business and marketing, and I entered the workforce through a graduate program with a business called National Mutual, which doesn't exist now. I moved to a textile business a few years later and came back to Adelaide, where I had been in Melbourne. And then here I worked in the automotive industry for a while. I then spent 15 years consulting, and out of the blue, in a connected kind of way, I was offered the opportunity to establish Food South Australia. It was too good to refuse, and I can honestly say it's been an amazing 13 years. So the key takeaway from this story is that networks and reputation open doors to opportunities. I've worked in the food and beverage sector for over 20 years. It's such a diverse industry with so many career opportunities across many disciplines. No 2 days are the same in my role, and COVID certainly taught us to be agile and responsive to every crisis. A lot of people don't understand what associations do. But in a time of crisis, associations are there to help members navigate through the issues. I worked very closely with the state government, recognised as the industry representative and the voice of our industry, and our Food South Australia membership has continued to grow from then to now. Our reason for being is to help our industry grow. We have 3 strategic pillars that we focus on: growing markets, growing capability and capacity, and growing connections, which includes the advocacy piece. As Janet said, we have a team in Adelaide and also an office in Japan and China. I've also had the good fortune to sit on a number of boards, as you heard. It gives me a great perspective to have had the experience of reporting to boards and also being on boards. So in summary, here's a few tips that I would like to share. In your career, you will get out of it what you put in. I've certainly found that. It's most rewarding when you love what you do. Personal brand and credibility is a critical element to success. Embrace opportunities and be a good listener. You never stop learning. Build your networks. People love to help you. But most importantly, have fun. The world is your oyster. And congratulations for selecting to enter such a wonderful industry wherever you go. Thank you.
On behalf of the graduates and their families attending today's ceremony, I would like to thank Ms. Catherine Sayer for her stimulating and inspiring address. We are honoured that you have taken the time to join us on this special day to share with us your thoughts and experiences. Your words of encouragement and advice are greatly appreciated. They remind us that education places upon each of us an enduring responsibility to make the best possible use of our talents and to contribute to the betterment of society, whatever way we can. Please join me once again in thanking Ms. Catherine Sayer.
I will now receive the candidates for degrees. I call on the Deputy Vice Chancellor of Research.
Ms. Janet Finley, I, Professor Anton Middleberg, Deputy Vice-Chancellor Research of the University of Adelaide, certify to you and the whole university that the graduates who will be presented to you have all fulfilled the required conditions prescribed for admission to the award for which they are so presented.
Thank you. Thank you. I, Janet Finlay, Chair of the Risk Committee of the University of Adelaide, by virtue of the power committed to me by the University, confirm that each graduate is admitted to the rank and privileges of a holder of the award in the University of Adelaide for which they are so presented. I call on the Deputy Dean, Research and Deputy Executive Dean of the Faculty of Sciences, Engineering and Technology, Professor Bronwyn Gelanders, to present the graduates.
Ms. Janet Finlay, I, Deputy Dean, Research and Deputy Executive Dean of the Faculty of Sciences, Engineering and Technology, Professor Bronwyn Gelanders, present to you graduates from the Faculty of Sciences, Engineering and Technology. To the degree of Bachelor of Viticulture and Oenology, James Yote Aldridge. Simon Paul Kiker. Martha Adeline Forrest. Thomas Riley Geyer. George James Grant. Nicholas George Guerin. William Henry Francis Johnson. Kylie Rose Ledson. Rongshen Li. Jeremy Little. Jack Christopher Manson. Fraser Marshall. James Rickard. Jake Matthew Rosenweg. Mason Skipworth. Joshua Smith. Max James Reginald Sneath. Janino Stanushi. And Francis Rory Pridham Worthington. To the degree of Bachelor of Science, Wildlife Conservation Biology, Tareva Sheehan Corrison Atkin Zaldiva. Jasmine Taylor Broadbridge. Natasha Jane Candy. Lachlan Joshua Charlton. Jenny Darcy. Charlotte Ebony Drake. Madeline Alice Harris. Nicole Fay Long. Laura Charlotte Mazzone. Emily Rebecca McCallan. Charlotte Rose Miles. Jack Wosley Petman. Taylor Joan Pitfield. Nicholas Daniel Rao. Sarah Jane Stewart. And Kylie Dawn Williams. To the degree of Bachelor of Science, Marine Biology, Mary Ellen Brownridge. Jock William Clark. Kenneth James Daniel. Friday Neve Dobson. Tamika Brooke Heath. Jessica Ruby Heyer. Francesco Guanhao Ho. Sushil Devshi Carson Jasani. Noah McNeil Kerikou. Ashley Mildrum. Nicholas Moy Koon Ping. Hannah Kate Nunn. Lena Gay. Janani Menaka Pereira. Ukayla Harini Raj. Amy Helen Rice. And Jasmine Doreen Tao. To the degree of Bachelor of Science, Biotechnology, Sarah Emily Booth. Annie Pauline Green. Malcolm Hang. Sing Hong Lo. And Wing Lei Foon Pham. to the degree of Bachelor of Science, Biomedical Science, Kashubu Agarwal. Angel Grace Allen. Mia Andrews. Aria Layla Arrell. Javita Aruna Salam. Jessica Emma Bullock. Eugene Chung. Rachel Wing Yen Chin. Ho Lam Chu. Louise Krista Del Castillo. Ishjot Dinsa. Sarah Jane Eisman. Rachel Marie Greenwood. Sadia Tasnim Hassan. Janath Arahiera. Dana Louise Holdroyd. Stephanie Rowanna Yankoff. Joyce Wong Hui Jing. Ryan Hao Bing Lee. Jia Vuan Lim. Justine Wan Yi Lo. Manhin Mack. Chi Tai Nguyen. Abdul Baez Safi. Stephanie Jane Scannell. Louisa Marie Tedesco. Sophie Frances Thompson. Matthew James Tidswell. Panatta Wanawong. Sylvie Rose Zyla Wiedner. Connor Liam Whitburn. Jia Hui Wong. and Megan Emma Zadeau. To the degree of Bachelor of Food and Nutrition Science, Yazid Muhammad S. Azam. Nicole Marie Alexandridis. Fan Bo. Melody Yan Lok Chan. Jordan Evan Chandranata. Si Ting Chung. Yam Leong Chu. Sarah Ghazali. Zara Jane Hollis. Fu Hin Kong. Ning Monica Lee. Shuan Lee. Karen Wee T. Low. Lisa Louise Manocchio. Michelle Weezy Rui. Pimpoon Jonathan Morley. Sanya Nasser Adin. Un Hui Nhu. Jainam Rajesh Kumar Patel. Tolan Ni Pham. Fanti Soon Kern. Nguyen Tien Pua. Ashini Ahera Rupa Singer. Jia Eun Sit. Tracy Shirotich Toe. Nathan Namgir Van. Rosa Verassi. And Linbo Wei. to the degree of Bachelor of Biotechnology, Suzanne Rajesh. And Katrina Louise Schiller. To the degree of Bachelor of Applied Biology, Ethan James Dyett. To the degree of Bachelor of Agricultural Sciences, Christopher Leonard Borden. Letizia Beauvoir. Lachlan James Bain. Henry Mitchell Brooks. William Charles Bryson. Hayden Lloyd Bubner. T. Chow Ang Kao. Jade Lily Collins. Edward Murray Downing. James David Easter. Jacob Ray Feiberger. Thomas Henry Follett. Tom Calvin Gamo. Cooper Richard Gladigo. Jack Darcy Hanna. Flynn Maxwell Hawes. Zara Madison Hicks. Matthew James Hill. Edward John Brian Holt Fanning. Cameron James Horseman. Yuyi Singh Lan. Sabrina Dawn Lawrence. Hector David McKenzie. Shannon Lee Maoji. Sean Thomas McNally. Alex James Newbold. Ling Xuan Ping. Ella K. Putland. Tess Louise Redden. Thomas Jordan Ritchie. Harrison Mark Shaw. Rebecca Ann Stevens. Anton James Traeger. Liam John Van Schaik. Jia Yi Yoon. Austin James Zangari. And Sarui Jong. To the honours degree of Bachelor of Viticulture and Oenology, Cadell Lachelle Canute. Maya Chowdhury. Will Charles Duff. Gianna Angela Femara. Georgina Claire Leskey. Samuel Peter Burns Parker. Samuel James Rowlands. And Jonathan David Ward. To the Graduate Diploma in Viticulture and Oenology, Benjamin Thomas Jeffrey Seibels. To the degree of Master of Viticulture and Oenology, Emily Kate Carney. To the degree of Master of Biotechnology, Biomedical, Hanbao Chen. Pei Chin Chua. Pak Xing Fan. Jia Hong Fan. Quan Long Lau. Cedar Liu. Chewy Law. Zoe Neringputhia. Kirti Maria Sabu. Shona Gillian Schwartz. Fang Maynor U Wu. And Ji Yao Young. To the degree of Master of Philosophy for a thesis entitled Formulation and Efficiency of Mycorrhizal Phosphatic Fertilizers, Burbikram Biswajre. And for a thesis entitled Exact Inference in Linear Mixed Models for Typical Agronomy Trials, Yiwen Li. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy for a thesis entitled Characterization of Ovarian Cancer Development, Progression and Treatment Resistance Through Mass Spectrometry Analysis, Dr. Mitchell Aidan Ackland. For a thesis entitled Forensic Trace DNA Recovery and Amplification from Metal and Metal-Coated Surfaces, Dr. Dan Nana Osai and Poonsar Mensah Bonsu. For a thesis entitled Nested Association Mapping of Wheat Yield Under Australian Drought and Heat Conditions, Dr. Charity Chidzanga. For a thesis entitled Post-Contact Evolutionary Immunogenetics in Indigenous Peoples of America, Dr. Evelyn Jane Collin. For a thesis entitled Precision Medicine Approaches for JAK2 Rearranged Acute Lymphoblastic Leukemia, the Efficacy of Targeted Therapies and Molecular Mechanisms of Drug Resistance, Dr. Charlotte Emma Jean Downs. For a thesis entitled Visual Evolution of Syncordia, Dr. Matthew John Robert Ford. For a thesis entitled Gut Microbiome Insights into the Pathophysiology of Inflammatory Bowel Disease, Dr. Gina Lucille Guzzo. For a thesis entitled Leptospermin for Bioactive Honey Production in South Australia, Selection, Genetic Diversity and Propagation, Dr. Tate Jason James Hancocks. For a thesis entitled Molecular Drivers of Aerobic Glycolysis in the Mammalian Retina, Dr. Cameron David Haydinger. For a thesis entitled Global Analysis of Genes Involved in Capsule Development and Seed Mucilage Polysaccharide Production in Plantago ovata, Dr. Lena Heraliana. For a thesis entitled Persistent Staphylococcus aureus Infection Through the Selection of Alternative Lifestyles, Dr. James Lee. for a thesis entitled Effect of Rising Sea Levels on the Geochemistry of Coastal Soils in Southern Australia, Dr. Emily Ruth Layden. For a thesis entitled Cover Crops, Carbon Dynamics and the Ecological Intensification of Vineyards, A View from Under the Vine, Dr. Joseph Nicholas John Marks. For a thesis entitled Investigating Galactose Metabolism in Streptococcus Pneumoniae, Dr. Kimberly Taylor McLean. For a thesis entitled The Role of GABA in Plant Salinity and Hypoxia Responses, Dr. Ying Ming. For a thesis entitled Herbicide Resistant Common Sow Thistle and Prickly Lettuce Management Considerations in Lentils, Dr. Elishu Blythe Merriam. For a thesis entitled Cephalic and Encephalic Arterial Anatomy and Perfusion in Birds and Mammals, Assessed via Microsphere Circulation, Contrast Injection and Osteoformina Measurement, Dr. Thomas Jack Nelson. For a thesis entitled Developing and Assessing Different Cordon Establishment Techniques for Long-Term Vineyard Management, Dr. Patrick Vaughan O'Brien. For a thesis entitled Quantifying and Reducing Biases in Paleogenomic Research, Dr. Adrian Oliver. For a thesis entitled Addressing Immunological Challenges to COVID-19 Vaccination, Dr. Griffith Board Perkins. For a thesis entitled Interrogating the Multi-Stress Tolerance of Oryza australiensis Using Novel Genomic and Phenomic Strategies, Dr. Aaron Lane Phillips. For a thesis entitled Reconstructing the Population History of Wallacea and Sahul, Dr. Gluduk Ario Panomo. For a thesis entitled Genetic Control of Seed Dormancy in Lolium rigidum and Bromus diandris, Dr. Zarka Ramas. For a thesis entitled Human Demographic Insights from Paleogenetic Studies of American and Iberian Skeletal Remains, Dr. Xavier Roccarada. For a thesis entitled Analysis of Plantago Species Variants for Novel Functional and In Vitro Fermentation Properties, Dr. Miguel Helvige, Denise Tharuka Jayampathy Silva. For a thesis entitled Evaluating Diagnostics and Mitigation of Smoke Exposure in Grapes and Wine, Dr. Colleen Zito. For a thesis entitled Improving the Adaptation of Wheat to Heat Stress Conditions, Dr. Paul Robert Telfer. for a thesis entitled Analysing Dynamics of the Illegal Wildlife Trade in Australia, Dr. Adam Toombs. For a thesis entitled Manipulating Grapevine Bud Fruitfulness, Shaoyi Wang. For a thesis entitled Varietal Thiols and Precursors, Biogenesis, Reactivity and Impact of Winemaking Practices, Dr. Xing Shen Wang. For a thesis entitled Characterising RNA-5-methylcytosine in A. thaliana, Functions and Regulation Pathways, Dr. Xing Yu Wu. And for a thesis entitled Symbiotic Effectiveness, Phylogenetic Diversity and Ecological Adaptation of Chickpea Rhizobia Isolated from Australian and Myanmar Soils, Dr. Mayant Zor. Ms. Janet Finlay, this concludes the graduates from the Faculty of Sciences, Engineering and Technology and for this ceremony.
Chair, Risk Committee. University doctoral research medals are awarded to graduates who have completed outstanding research at doctoral level. This award is the premier award for doctoral candidates at the university. I, Professor Anton Middleberg, Deputy Vice Chancellor Research of the University of Adelaide, present to you a recipient of the 2022 University Doctoral Research Medal. For research in the field of molecular and biomedical science, Stuart Paul DePoy. For research in the field of agriculture, food and wine, Ranawira Kalarachiga Ruchira Ranawira.
I'm very pleased to present to you Glurug Ario Ponomo, who was presented this afternoon with the Doctor of Philosophy. Glurug Ario Ponomo will now give the valedictory address on behalf of the cohort of graduates who were presented with their awards today.
I never imagined that a series of small decisions would lead me to Adelaide. From leaving my hometown 18, 20 years ago, to the single email that I sent to my supervisor 5 years ago, changed my life dramatically. For 10 years, I've been working on the research institute, collaborating with prominent researchers worldwide, but still unable to seize the opportunity to pursue my degree. But small, single email, no more than 20 words, was finally given to opportunity to further my education. The long-awaited moment has come. I am now graduated from the University of Adelaide. I remember the first year went by so quickly. I treat it as business as usual. I'm able to adapt to the change and adversity in the university life. Then the following years, everything went wrong. Like a hurricane which annihilated everything in the path. And as I progressed, the situation worsened during the pandemic, during the darkest hour. But I found friends, mentor. As Euripides of Athens said, a true friendship is shown in the time of troubles. And now, six of us sitting in the very same room to be graduated today. The university experience is our capital to venture into the world. It's a basic life lesson 101. It is the duty of the university to provide a safe environment for us to grow and excel in our field. But the story does not end here. When we walk out of this hall, the world awaits us. The world of deception, yet full of opportunity, lay in our path. It is up to us whether we take and fight for it or just let it drift. Don't be afraid to take a risk and fail. We've learned in our past that failure is part of our life. The fact that we are seated here demonstrates that we were able to learn from our mistake, yet rise again and again to meet the challenge. The universe behaves in an unusual manner. Our decision, no matter how small it is, may greatly impact our life. Let's keep our head held high and embrace the world. On this occasion, I would like to thank my parents for honoring and trusting my decision since the beginning of my journey, as well as my younger brother, who finally stepped forward to care of the family. Thanks to my girlfriend, who always been an inspiration to me and has never lost faith through me throughout this journey. Now, I would like to request that my fellow graduate to stand up and look across the hall. In the last 45 minutes, I always hear a shout, clapping, and I can see proud moment from this side of the hall. This moment will not possible without amazing family, wonderful friends, and all of the entire academic staff in this university. For that, let's give them big applause for their unwavering support. Lastly, congratulations for my fellow graduates and best wish to you for the next venture. The world is waiting for us. Thank you.
It now gives me great pleasure to congratulate all of the new graduates here today. Be proud of what you have worked to achieve and remember those who have supported you to reach this end. I wish you every success as you enter this next exciting stage of your life and your career. As graduates of the University of Adelaide, you are also its alumni and ambassadors. Over the years since the university was established, its alumni have made an enormous contribution to the community, both here and throughout the world. And today you join this community of over 150,000 alumni, located in more than 135 countries around the globe. We also have 21 global alumni networks, including 8 international networks. I would like to take this opportunity to thank the mace bearer and valedictorian, and all who assisted the university in the running of today's ceremony. I ask all of the graduates to remain seated, and I invite everyone else here to stand and once again join me in congratulating the graduates on their wonderful achievements. Thank you. Would the audience remain standing? And the graduates now please stand for the academic recession. Once the academic recession has left the hall, we ask guests to please remain at your seats until directed to exit by our staff. I now declare this congregation adjourned. Well done.